We support a condition type that will do an SQC test, a statistical quality control test. Now, this is a huge topic. We talk a lot about SQC in some of our other applications. So for example, if you want to know more about SQC in general, statistical quality control, go out to our tech support website. Take a look under the products for either of these, SQC Alarm Manager or the SQC Process Book add-in. Yeah, we have a lot more to say about SQC in general, about these different, the Western Electric pattern tests that you see here as an option. So what we're intending for you to do here is, you know, for somebody who's familiar already with statistical quality control and somebody who has some control limits in mind, somebody who already knows what the control limits are because they've derived them elsewhere, either from our packages or from some other package, then you could implement an SQC-based notification. So it would work like this. I would go out and find an attribute like that attribute that we've been testing against all along here. That's an attribute of an element. And then I would specify the upper control limit, the center line, and the lower control limit also as element attributes. So let me just go back there and show you these element attributes. I added a couple of extras here, attribute 1, 2, and 3. Oh, let's say we're going to do this as our upper control limit. And we'll make this our lower control limit. And we'll make this our center line. And give these values. Oh, let's say this is 90, this is 88, and this is 86. And these are things that we've derived elsewhere. We've learned from experience these are good control limits for this particular tag. Of course, that doesn't really look like that with that at 300, but let's just say that's the situation. That's how we can, that's how we've got this set up in advance. I'll go ahead and check these in, and now I'm ready to build a notification that makes use of that structure. So in here, in under notifications, let me go ahead and add, not a whole new notification, let's just add a condition to this. We'll do an SQC alarm. That's the source tag we're interested in tracking. And for our upper and upper control limit, center line, etc., we're going to use those things we just defined over in this same element called monitor tags. Oop, there we go. There's our lower control limit. Now for the pattern you want to use, you can choose any of these that you like. These are the standard Western Electric test patterns. This outside control is the standard the three standard deviations test. So this essentially means if one out of one value coming in from this element attribute is outside three standard deviations, then we send the notification. Or you can say if two out of three are outside two standard deviations, or four out of five, or three out of five. It's up to you. And we typically suggest people start out slow with any kind of SQC, simply because if you turn on all of these, you're going to just pummel people with all kinds of notifications that are probably, you know, fairly difficult and obscure to interpret. So it's always good to start small. I mean, if you've got a real good group that knows the difference between, you know, outside three standard deviations and a stratification alarm, then that's something you can, of course, choose to do. But we generally recommend you start small. So having done all this, what we should see as a result is that if we have anything that goes outside those limits, we're going to see that type of notification. Okay, so let's go ahead and push this. I'll push this to 92. Let's go with 93. I'll save this. And that should trigger this as an SQC alarm. So let's go over here and watch this alarm show up. Okay. And if you take a look, it looks like we just got an alarm that came in. The alarm's being identified as outside control, because that's in fact what it is. It's outside the three standard deviations. If we click here, you can see that's the one test we chose to use there. So that's our SQC. As I said, if you're interested in more information about SQCs, please go out and take a look at our SQC Alarm Manager or our SQC Add-in to Process Book. Now, one final thing, if you've got our SQC Alarm Manager already generating alarms, SQC alarms, there's no reason for you to use this to provide notifications for those alarms. What you can simply do at that point is do a new comparison condition and look for you know, that value, that SQC alarm, to be equal to the string outside control. So, you know, if you have existing alarms in the system, you can simply use the regular comparison tool with the notifications to send an alarm based on them.